What's up, guys? Welcome to the Pete's Basement Christmas special. We're gonna give away these awesome four Star Wars holiday banks. We're gonna talk about the Star Wars movie. No spoilers, so don't worry. And we got some pretty cool comics to talk about, such as Dragon Age Magekiller, number one. We got DC's Lucifer, volume two, number one. Judge Dredd. We got Cops for Criminals. From Locust Moon, we got Prometheus Eternal. And from Marvel, we got the Squadron Supreme, issue one, Starbrans, and Nightmask, and Weirdworld. And we're also going to talk about Darth Vader Annual, number one. It is Star Wars week, you know. I'm not sure if you guys realize, but like Star Wars came out this week. So why don't you watch this intro, and we'll be right back, and we're going to talk about it. Salute. Before we go and give away these pretty awesome banks, we got Darth Vader over here. We got Darth Maul right behind. And you guys can see the Stormtrooper and Boba Fett.
Wait, who's this guy?
That's Darth Maul.
Where is he from? He's from Star Wars?
He was from these old TV episodes from way back when in the 60s.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, the B. Arthur one.
Yes, yes.
Oh, that was B. Arthur.
That is, in fact, okay. B. Arthur.
Right. Yeah,
I remember. Darth Maul.
Have you guys out there, like, if you call yourselves Star Wars fans, have you, in fact, seen the Star Wars holiday special? Because I don't think you're allowed to call yourself a fan if you haven't sat through an hour and a half special where the first 15 minutes is in Wookiee.
Seriously?
With no subtitles. It's purely Wookiee. Our dear Trish, Rich's wife, is raising her hand in the studio audience.
Do you celebrate Life Day, Trish?
Sure.
It's the Wookiee holiday.
That is, in fact, the Wookiee holiday for Christmas, Life Day. And the plot of this is Han is trying to get Chewie home for Life Day, and they're running into all sorts of Imperial problems along the way.
Forget about Wookiee porn.
Wookiee porn? Oh God, I was really
hoping to forget.
Chewie's dad was actually masturbating to Wookiee porn in one of the scenes. He puts on this little virtual reality helmet in this like magic fingers kind of seat. I'm not lying to you. This is not made up at all. This is fucking happening.
I was really stoned at the time.
I don't think you can watch this sober.
Yeah.
It's not fair to you to watch it sober. B. Arthur is in this, and she sings.
I know.
She sings to get everyone out of the cantina because it's closing. So in order to force them out, she starts to sing. That's like something I would do.
Yeah, totally.
It is also, however, the first appearance of Boba Fett in a little animated feature that puts the horrendous animation of Yellow Submarine to shame. It makes Yellow Submarine look like fucking Ninja Scroll.
Careful. Okay, wow. That's a really good analogy, dude.
I know.
And Ramon approves.
Yeah, huh?
Ninja
Pete tested, Ramon approved. Just like Life cereal.
I'm no fan.
So, a spoiler-free review of Star Wars, because I know a lot of you guys out there have not seen it. So, spoiler-free, I will say the movie absolutely lives up to the hype. I enjoyed it immensely. It has a few points where I'm like, it could have been a little better, or why did they do that? But
sure.
Overall,
yeah.
I thoroughly enjoyed it. I laughed, I cried, I stood up and clapped at the end of the credits. There is no scene that I cried. I was, without spoilers,
I cried.
I was upset. So, Dimitrios, welcome back to the program, brother.
Thank you very much, my friend.
You know, we always got whiskey for you when you come.
Yeah, I need it.
And lots of it.
So, right off the bat, now you have finally produced a Millennials comic issue one, apparently.
Issue one.
The Kickstarter, or was it Indiegogo, sir?
Indiegogo.
Well, it was a raging success. Uh-huh. My character lives, though he does not yet appear in this book yet. Mm-hmm. What issue am I?
Issue three.
Issue three, all right. So this means like, you got to get to stepping because I want to see me in print and in living color.
Script's done.
All right.
They're still finishing the art on issue two. But
so we've got Millennials over here. We also feature the first ever full page ad for the Pete's Basement Show. Check that out right in the back.
Yeah, yeah.
Featuring the awesome artwork by Rick Sellis. me and Ramon and all our amazing Fantasy 15-ish glory.
I thought that was Jack Kirby, man.
Kind of resembles it, doesn't it?
It does.
So why don't you tell us about what's going on here? Basically, these kids are in debt up to their ears.
Right.
And they're majoring in things that could never possibly make them any money to pay off aforementioned debt. And they've got sentinels coming after them.
Debt collectors coming after them. So the U.S. government has decided that millennials owe so much money to college debt that they will, instead of collecting it, put them into enslavement camps and stuff so they could work it off. It's the most logical thing. And so they've used the education money to create robots to hunt them down and capture them and stuff.
How do they develop these superpowers? Is it the debt that gives them the powers?
No. Millennials in this comic, in this world, have powers. They're special. That's why the title is Millennials, You Are Special. Mm-hmm. They're all, every millennial has a power in some way, shape, or form. It's really, they're like mutants, essentially.
Now, is there an age gap? Like, what is the age brackets for millennials? Because I've actually never understood that. I know I'm not one.
Yeah.
I'm going to be 35 in 2 weeks. So I know
you and me both.
You're right outside, actually, Pete.
So what is the millennial...
According to like most of the consensus and stuff, it varies, honestly. You actually might qualify, I'll be honest with you. Personality-wise, the fact that you actually have a show... That's online. That you're actually kind of more millennial than other people younger than you, believe it or not.
Mm-hmm.
Your interest in comics.
Very much on thin ice.
Look, there's an idea that a millennial is a type of thinking, and then there's a strict age. You know, so like they usually say 1980 through 1995 are all millennials, essentially. That's what they usually say.
I always figured, I thought it was actually like 1993-ish and up.
No. It's much younger. It's the people who entered the working force around the millennium, actually, like 2000 and stuff, or people who were in college around that
time. I think we should beat the shit out of all of those people until they change their minds.
One of them, man.
And how old are you?
Other people. I'm 32 right now.
All right, so we should just make this like really like 29 and under from here on in, I think. This way we're all kind of saved.
Right. Well,
because I don't have no college debt, man. I went to a SUNY school.
Oh, me neither.
I paid $2,500 a year for tuition, so fuck that noise.
SUNY, $8,000, I think, mm-hmm.
I'm still paying off my debt.
Well, it's all satire. The idea is that, like, millennials, they all want attention. They're all exposed to television and YouTube videos and stuff and everything, so...
So you're saying that me having a podcast is kind of a cry for attention?
Yeah. Well, no, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that other...
I'm saying that. Roger's saying that.
I just want you guys to like me.
I'm saying...
Somebody has to like me.
I didn't have friends growing up. That's actually not true, but I just want everybody to like me.
Did those friends like you?
Not really. Trish, did you guys like me, or did you just kind of tolerate me?
Loved.
That hesitation.
She's taking entirely too long to think about. I should never have made this multiple choice.
I loved you. I didn't like you.
There we go.
That makes sense.
Family for you.
She'd love to abuse you.
That's true.
Had you been a millennial, Pete, your lifestyle would make more sense. I'll put it like that.
Fair enough. I've always been a little behind the times. I like to think I'm still a bit of an 11-year-old up here. 11 because it's still cute that I play with toys, but it's not weird that I like tits. Because it was around 11 that I realized like my fifth grade teacher was really hot.
I will say one thing, though. When you debut in the story, and I didn't know you were slightly older than me, Pete, but... You are a millennial in this universe,
I understand,
by the way.
I understand.
That's how you have powers. You will have powers. Surprise powers, but you will have powers.
Now, wait a minute. I'm a little concerned about these powers, matter of fact, because unbeknownst to me at the time, you had a personal conversation with Roger.
Correct.
Who decided on my whole power
base. Correct.
I'm nice. Afraid.
I'm not going to tell you what it is. I will give you one clue. It has nothing to do with masturbation.
Well, that's probably fortunate.
That's your only clue. Figure it out from that.
It kind of opens up just a really broad spectrum of other ideas. Since we're going to leave this one alone.
I thought that was a really good clue, actually. All right. Fair enough.
Well, so how did you come up with this, and where can people find this book?
Oh, okay. Right, currently, Millennials, okay, the Indiegogo helped pay for the artistic team, which were incredible.
Art is really great in this,
yeah,
by the way.
Thank you very much. Guillermo Villarreal, who you could find online, and Tom Griffin, who has been a guest on the show before. In using the Indiegogo didn't reach its goal. We were trying to raise $9,000, which would have paid for printing, artistic talent, and the artistic talent would have been higher tier then. But as it was, I found a really talented guy with a lower tier pay rate, and I paid for printing out of pocket, right? Mm. It's fine, no complaints. I'm very thankful for what I have already. But when I did print it, it's actually a really low print run as a result. So we've submitted it to Diamond Distribution, which will be like thousands or whatever. Mm-hmm. But right now, assuming all the stores pick it up, it'll be thousands, but it'll be second printings. So right now, Midtown Comics has a few. Pete has some first printings. If Diamond, I don't see them not agreeing to this. When Diamond picks it up, we're forced to only do second printings of the book. So if you guys want to order them off the Griffinites website, order them off of MidtownComics.com, or come to the stores. I work at the Grand Central store. I could sign it for you too. But yes, the print run is extremely low on this one, just because that's all we have. We happen to have
two or three copies to give away, which Dimitrios is going to be kind enough to sign. And as of right now, we've got three copies, which are actually over on our production table way over there. So I don't get to show them to you, but here's an example. This is my copy. You can't have this one.
You can't have it.
Nope. However, since we're lacking for a contest to start the new year with, 2016,
yeah,
why don't we start the year with the Millennials contest?
Right.
And, you know, it's kind of like, it's a new year, it's a millennial thing.
Yeah.
We're 16 years from the millennium. It's a that's a bit of a science fiction fact for you.
Sure, sure.
Stanley Kubrick and his buddy Hal don't look so weird no more.
Nope. You know?
It's kind of scary. But nevertheless,
my dream, Dave.
I can't do that, Dave. Dave.
I saw it once, and it was kind of a waste of three hours of my life.
If you do smoke up, that's the only movie you need to have in the background. It'll change your life.
I think you need heroin for that movie. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yes. Great movie, I've seen.
Since they can't really answer a question about the book itself,
yeah,
being that they may not have it and they're only able to get it from Midtown, and
sure,
they wouldn't order the book then to just win the book.
Uh-huh.
What sort of trivia question would you like to throw at them?
Oh, shit. Ooh.
How about
asking him?
I'm a comic.
He knows his shit too much.
Yeah. He is good at it. Well, I mean, something simple that they, you know, something that might be Googleable for them.
Okay, yeah. Definitely, yeah.
By the way, hi, Rick Sellers.
How you doing, Rick Sellers?
What's up, Rick?
Nobody told me he was on. I can't see the shit.
Well, you guys were in the middle of such riveting conversation, I didn't want to interrupt.
You can interrupt. That's what people do. It's a talk show. It's not the Pete Show. It's just called Pete's Basement because that was the accidental title. Seriously, it was a total accident 8 years ago.
A Googleable question?
A Googleable question.
Okay.
What about,
I got one.
All right, go for it. Here. Yeah.
All right. Of course I do. So I'm assuming you guys, all over the internet, you guys love your Arrow TV show and stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Who was in DC Comics universe pre-Christ Infinite Earths, all that stuff, whatever? Who was the first Arsenal? Describe him, and what book did Arsenal, the very first Arsenal appear in? I'll give you a clue. It's not Roy Harper, and he doesn't have a bow and arrow at all.
Ooh.
Ah. Okay.
Even I don't know that one.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to Google that shit my damn self. All right, guys. So there's your question. Pre-52, pre-crisis. So this is going back before the 1980s. Who was the first Arsenal? And what book did he first appear in?
Right.
Yep.
Simple enough.
Do they have to answer both parts of those questions?
If you answer one, you'll answer the other for sure.
Okay, fair enough.
Like, it'll, you know.
One will lead into the other.
Yeah, one will.
So in theory, you should be able to wiki this. And you can get to the wiki page by Googling it. You might say the answer is Googleable. It's going to be a thing, guys. It's going to be a thing.
Nothing to do with Green Arrow. Nothing to do with Green Arrow.
Nice. All right. So, book of the week. It is Star Wars week. It is Star Wars day, as a matter of fact.
This book of the week is a coincidence, though.
I know. We did not plan this.
No.
We didn't get paid for this. Lucas is not giving us dick for this.
Well,
we didn't even
Disney.
Get...
It's, yeah, it's Disney, Disney not Disney.
Well, it's... Lucas was bought by Disney. Somebody actually asked us that. I posted up a great photo of Kylo Ren with some stormtroopers behind him, and it said, okay, Marvel and DC, you've had your fun. Now it's time for the big boys to play. And somebody said, but isn't Star Wars a Marvel product? And I said, no, not quite. Marvel was bought by Disney, just like Lucasfilm was bought by Disney. So maybe they're cousins.
Yeah, I'll go with that. Sure. Distant, maybe distant cousins.
Yeah, like second, you know. Third.
Mm-hmm. I would love to see Lucas's reaction to this movie. By the way, I would love to be in the theater with George Lucas to see what he would say.
You know, actually, what was it? Today is George Lucas's birthday.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Oh. And Lucas.
Did they plan that
movie too? By the way.
Oh, he did.
What's that?
Yeah, Lucas. Lucas did, and after. I think it came out like last week or something like that. He said he liked the movie.
Today is George Lucas's birthday.
Happy birthday, George.
Well, happy birthday, George. I'm glad you didn't have your grubby, stubby hands in this one, lest we had another prequel problem.
You can't deny it. It's not true. Yeah.
I would love to hear what he would say. He would like to change. He would have changed or done differently in this movie. Mm-hmm.
He would have introduced more Medichlorians, of course. I'm pretty sure that's the stuff you put in your galactic swimming pool to clean it up.
Jar Jar's children.
That's funny.
Thank you, sir. I really expected a better laugh for that.
Just gonna. Actually, no.
Almond Gallery.
Actually, what's funny is they lied on the internet. It's not his birthday.
It is not his birthday.
The internet lied.
Should I throw this shot up back into my glass?
No, they posted on USA Today. It's actually false.
The internet doesn't lie.
Yeah.
Who told you that?
The internet.
then don't trust the internet for the Arsenal answer in that case.
Yeah, by the way.
No, I'm serious. The USA Today said that today was George Lucas' birthday, but I just looked it up. It's not.
First of all, this is USA Today. Let's put that
in. Yeah. There's a reason why it's free in every hotel.
Are you telling me that the five times Chuck Norris died weren't true?
Oh, no. How do they enter the Griffin Knights contest? How do they enter the Millennium?
How should they enter the Griffin Knights contest? I'm going to tell you how right now. You're going to email us with the correct answer, and you're going to title that shit Millennials. And if you can't spell that, just do the best you can. There's a couple of N's and some L's in there.
If you can't spell it, just Google it. That's definitely Googleable.
Damn right. Just email us at questions@peachbasement.com, title it Millennials, and pop in your answer right there in the body of the email. If you want to make things easier, you can put your address underneath. Like when you properly, like, you know, address a letter.
No one knows how to do that anymore, man.
No one does.
Yeah, no one
does. No one at all.
It's a dying art.
Otherwise, then we have to write to you and ask you for your address when you win the contest. Remember, we're giving away three of these, which Dimitrios is going to sign for you. And while we're at it, Ramon and I will sign the back page because we're just egotistical assholes and we want to fucking sign it for you.
Give Rick a nice view of that art.
Give Rick a nice view of the art. He's seen it, man. He drew the shit.
Yeah, but maybe he didn't know it's in there.
He's got the original.
Rick, you're being advertised for the first time in a comic.
Yes, it does say at the bottom that it's art by Rick Sellers.
Damn right. We wouldn't leave that shit out.
I'm not going to keep you out of that.
Definitely not. So, Darth Vader Annual number 1.
Yes.
Ooh. You enjoyed this immensely.
A lot.
Art was very good.
And normally we just do the number 1s, and we usually skip annuals.
Truthfully.
Usually.
Because most of the time annuals suck balls.
Yeah.
Yeah, lately, yeah.
I mean, every annual that I've had to read for this show, I've, you know, up until, well, I missed out on this one too, but I skipped them all because, again, I read like the first 3 pages, I'm like, done.
I think the last time I actually enjoyed an annual, it was Spidey's Totally Tiny Adventure.
What was that? I don't remember that.
No, Spidey's Totally Tiny Adventure was when, back in the 92 or so, he teamed up with Ant-Man.
Mm-hmm.
I forget what happened to him, that he started shrinking, shrunk Ant-Man? Into the very microverse. They encountered Psycho Man.
In the 90s, they didn't invent
Early
Viagra 90s. Yet.
They did not invent Viagra.
That's why he's shrinking.
Well, he might have just jumped in a cold swimming pool.
Okay, fair enough.
Oh,
I was in the pool!
So they encountered Psycho Man?
Yeah, man. It was a really good story. The year after that, they did the Vibranium Vendetta.
Ooh.
It was good shit, man.
Mid-90s, they did that X-Men annual crossover, the Shadow Shot. That was wasn't bad.
I remember the Korvac Quest. That was an X-Men, New Mutants. God, I forget who else. That was the thing about the 90s, man. That made crossovers So, and I was just explaining this the other day to people. What pisses me off about all of these new Marvel and DC events is everybody's everywhere. Do you remember, like, when it just used to be a supervillain attacks, the hero deals with the problem for a couple of issues, and on to the next problem?
Yeah.
And a guest appearance was a, wow, it was a big event. Yeah. Yo, man, look, Moon Knight's guest starring in Spider-Man. Right. Holy shit, Round Robin has fucking everybody in it.
That was an awesome, awesome.
You guys are remembering.
That was a
very
great story arc.
But that was
Round
like.
Round Robin.
That was
the
was
sidekick's
so
revenge, yo.
That was great.
I remember it. It wasn't, it was, yeah, I wasn't thinking Batman, but it wasn't great, man. By the way, your boy Bagley drew that.
It was fun as hell to read, though.
Dimitrios on the storyline was kind of
It was kind of a whack story, but nevertheless.
Had everybody.
Right.
Had everybody. Exactly. Well, then
it was awesome.
And you warriors and Punisher, basically.
Right.
And
these days, everybody's a fucking Avenger.
Yeah, in fairness, they're comparing that crap back then to the current events.
But by the way, who's your favorite?
So technically,
right,
it still is better than the current
Avenger. My favorite Avenger right now? Yeah. Who the fuck is still an Avenger?
Mine is Cable. Cable's an Avenger now. My favorite Avenger is Cable, by the way.
I'm going with Deadpool on this.
That's a good one. They're both Avengers.
I'm going with Deadpool just because he likes chimichangas. That's about it.
2015, Deadpool and Cable are Avengers. Would you have imagined that back when you were reading comics in the 90s,
no.
Man?
No.
That's
way.
So fucking ridiculous.
Adriel Jimenez.
What?
Adriel.
Adriel Jimenez. What's up, brother?
I mean, the fact, I don't know, I just find it really silly that Cable is an Avenger because he was more of a loner than even Wolverine.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so, Wolverine's on every team.
I remember reading
some stuff. He's kind of a loner. He did start the New Mutants, I mean the X-Force.
Yeah, but still. Like,
but yeah, he shouldn't be like, he should be the boss if he's going to be on a team.
I was
right.
I was
You're
reading
not
early,
the boss of me now.
I was reading early Spider-Man, Ditko Spider-Man stuff, and they explicitly said that Spider-Man's too much of a loner. He doesn't belong on any team. They explicitly said this.
Okay. Right.
So let's go back to Book of the Week. Let's talk Darth Vader Annual. You loved this.
I did.
For like one particular scene. Basically, it is this king who, you know, his whole kingdom works for the Empire.
Yeah.
They're kind of forced to. They don't really have a choice in this matter. They're doing some mining for the Empire, whatever it is.
Exactly.
And Darth Vader comes to oversee, make sure everything's copacetic, because maybe he got, like, they got chintzed in their last report.
Because the Death Star just got destroyed.
Right.
So people might get the idea that, okay, maybe we could rebel because obviously you're fucking weak.
Yeah.
So he comes bearing a gift. And before he gets a chance to give this gift, they put him into a trap. This trap fails miserably because this is Darth Vader and he's...
Both traps.
Yeah. And he's just a badass. He's just fucking people up left and right.
All right,
and
can I guess what the trap is?
Sure.
A
woman comes out saying his kid, the kid is his, basically. Like, it's a Maury Povich type trap. Is that what it was? The kid is yours.
That'd be an awesome little thing to draw, though. Darth Vader and Maury Povich.
It'd
be funny.
I would pay money to see that. Yeah. I would pay money to see that.
Okay. If Maury had any sense, he would have done that show today.
Luke. So,
it's the king.
Darth is your father.
Why didn't you love me?
And you can just throw in so many lines.
I know.
We could rule the galaxy together as father and son. I just wanted to play catch, Dad.
I just wanted to play catch the lightsaber.
Darth Vader.
Wow, that's double entendre. Holy shit.
Darth Vader's not paying child support, and then he's brought onto the show. And
then, oh, wow.
are the father.
Luke walks out all thugged out and shit.
So what is the present that Vader brings to...
So after he deals with the king, his son, and the oldest daughter... he throws the present at the last remaining princess.
It's a rock.
And it's a rock. And he's like,
Dwayne Johnson.
This is all that's left of Alderaan. The last people who went against us.
So remember, the Empire can either be a very generous friend or a very dangerous enemy.
He uses the Force to take the crown from the father
and
places it on her head. You rule this planet, but you work for us. And he walks away.
And he's like, deuces. And yo, how badass were those fucking droids? A C-3PO and an R2 unit
that
were just fucking, like,
from the
killers.
Main story, they just kill. And it's just badass.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just...
But they still, like, they still talk with the same kind of C-3PO mannerism, but he's a killer. He's like, yes, I've brought all my poisons. Don't worry. And like this thing's like, beep, 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 beep. And he's like, well, they did technically have heart attacks. You shot them in the heart. I would have aimed for their stomach, and it would have hurt more. Wow. Yo, the droids would have made the whole book
for fucked
me.
Up. Yeah, yeah. That's fucked up.
Why a spoon, cousin? You're
because it's dull, you twits. It'll hurt more.
And speaking of Alan Rickman, it's not Christmas to me until I've seen him fall off Nakatomi Plaza. So,
what? Die Hard. Come on.
Seriously?
Really?
I don't remember people's names like that. He knows
my God.
I am shit.
There were two
with
kinds
names.
Of people well, in this
two,
world.
There's two Christmas films, because okay. The other one he's
Severus
in is Love Actually.
Falls off of,
okay, see, I remember that more.
There are two kinds of people in this world, folks.
He doesn't cast Wingardium Leviosa.
The kinds of people who think that Die Hard is not a Christmas movie, and those who are wrong.
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
Next up, is El Sinestro watching by any chance?
I don't think so.
Have we seen him yet?
I don't think so.
I just want to issue out a thanks to him. First of all, congratulations on the birth of your son. He is very cute. That yeah. boy is going to have a hell of a time with all of Dad's toys. So yes. Here's to you, sir.
Cheers.
El Sinestro. You're watching our stupid show after
actually,
priorities, El Sinestro.
He's probably watching Star Wars right now.
Mm. That's
fair
true.
Enough, for the fifth time.
Yep.
Yeah.
I also picked up this little Link 8-bit thingy. I think it's a magnet. So we're going to open this right on
I
the
I so
air
badly
here.
Want that. I have to get one.
And there's a bunch of dorks everywhere who just silently
cry
out.
Yeah.
Why dude, you open the package.
Open your
man?
Toys, hey, man. Just, yeah. The toys want to be played with.
We're just going to like get stills of this and do hashtag nerdgasm.
It was, as if a million voices cried and then were silenced.
I don't know what it is. I don't think it's a magnet.
It's a eraser.
Well, I'll test it out.
You got it, something metal?
No, it's not a magnet.
Was that when you were in the war?
It was when I was in the war.
And El Sinestro was also very kind to send us several Christmas gifts. We don't really encourage that, but it was very nice of him to do. He sent us a Would You Rather picture game,
nice.
Which is Would You Rather, for example, wear your grandmother's wardrobe? Right. Or wear a King Cobra as a necktie.
King Cobra.
I think I'm gonna go with the grandma's wardrobe there.
Let me read one.
Would
you rather Jar Jar Binks was in a spin-off movie or the Ewoks made up Kylo Ren?
That's fucked up.
Like they made him up.
Yeah, I'm thinking Jar Jar.
Like they just—he was a figment of their wub imagination.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or do you mean like Kylo Ren was actually just two Ewoks stacked together?
Yeah, it says two Ewoks stacked together make up Kylo Ren. Which one would you rather be?
Jar Jar.
I think I'm gonna go with the Jar Jar Binks spin-off movie.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. I would totally see a Jar Jar Binks spin-off movie.
Yeah.
I would. I could get really, really stoned and drunk and then go.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe that worked then.
Yeah, I think it would be fucking fantastic.
Either that or you might have to drop acid for that.
We also got the Ultimate Dirty Joke Book.
Nice.
Which is pretty cool. Let's just draw an example here. Let's try and get
Find a short one.
Yeah, we're going. What is the logo for the new Irish tampon? We may not be number one, but we're still up there. I don't...
Wow.
Oh, okay.
Okay, wait a minute. A husband and wife are in bed. The husband asks his wife if she wants sex. I'm sorry, honey, she said. Oh, no, this is the dental appointment one. We all know that one. I've got a gynecologist appointment tomorrow, and he says I have to be fresh. And husband thinks about it for a second, says, do you have a dentist appointment too? This might be a good one. A husband wakes his wife up at 2 in the morning. I'm feeling really horny, he says. Any chance of a blowjob? I'm too tired, the wife groans. Tell you what, why don't you jerk off into that glass and I'll drink it in the morning? That's good!
Wow.
That's fucking good. Thank you, El Sinestro. And last but not least, I mean, this is above and beyond the Call of Duty, but this...
Holy shit.
This
dude,
is
really?
Fucking awesome. Holy the shit. Giant-ass Groot. I mean, look at this damn thing.
We are Groot.
Well, I'm going to have to rearrange the shelves in the basement now to accommodate this big bastard.
That is awesome.
There's like a Hot Toys. It's got all the different limbs and stuff and all kinds of craziness going on in here.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, sir. being that I am Italian, I don't know how to just accept stuff, so you can expect plenty of baby toys for you, your daughter, and I don't know, something that I can come up with for you and the missus. But thank you very much. You have made it a very nice basement Christmas, and cool. We hope to return the favor. So here's to you, sir. Salute.
Cheers.
If we had a hat on, it would be off already. Thank you very much to one of our truest fans for ages now.
Seriously.
Dude, I got an idea for $1 million idea for Disney.
Okay.
A group Christmas tree.
Wow.
Somebody actually customized a group. They put it on the top of it and a stuffed rocket raccoon next to it. Yeah.
That's amazing.
Right?
That's awesome.
But to market something like that would be absolutely
brilliant. Man.
Yeah, absolutely.
I would put ornaments on that Groot hot toy, man.
Just so happened.
Yep.
I do want to also shout out for any of you who collect toys and stuff like that. I highly encourage you to go and listen to Two's Company, Three's a Podcast, which is our boy El Sinestro's podcast. Go there for all of your toy collecting needs. This dude knows toys like Pete's Basement knows comics.
Yeah, or just to know toys and check them out.
If you don't know toys and you want to get into toys, or if you're looking for toys to go pick up for a 5-year-old or something like that, he's got it covered.
Yep.
Nice.
Me, I want to ask him which Devastator I need to get, because if you've ever seen, they make, there's like 3 or 4 different third-party companies that make Transformers toys.
Really?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. And some of like the combiner ones are ridiculous.
That's awesome.
Yeah, you know, they're like this big. They all got all sorts of crazy details and shit. And I've always wanted a Devastator
since I
was a little kid.
Extermination.
I
don't know that. Which one is that from?
Movie.
I don't remember that. The only one I remember from the movie was when is it Ironhide or something? He's like, oh no, Devastator, and like right before he just rips the fucking ceiling off of the ship.
Did you read Combiner Wars, man?
I'm a little behind on Combiner Wars, but I was reading it.
I'm gonna spoil it for you.
Okay.
Fucking Optimus with Prowl and Ironhide, and I forgot who else becomes a combiner, dude. He becomes Optimus Supreme or something like that. Dude, that's it was sick. The most amazing thing ever, man.
You fell off Combiner Wars,
yeah,
too, right?
Yeah, totally. That Transformers period.
Dude, Optimus becomes a combiner, man.
No, that sounds interesting. Nuts.
Yo, the toys for Combiner Wars are ridiculous.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You had a couple in the shop that I was just totally fawning over. Even like Motor Master, which was one of my first Transformers that I ever got.
For Devastator, right?
Motor Master was Bruticus.
Oh, Bruticus, right.
I heard Bruticus.
And it looks so good.
Optimus Menage a Trois.
I saw the Megastar shit.
Vegetable
too. Chose a Rust the other day.
Yeah.
Yo. The only thing that bothers me is, and I guess, you know, what fucking the world is the way it is today, on the pussification of fucking America's youth, they can't have Megatron turn into a gun. They make him turn into a tank instead.
Yeah, that's some bitch-ass shit.
Dude, you know what I would love to have seen?
Megatron turns into a fucking Welter P-38, motherfuckers.
Dude.
And we'll get shot with that if you walk into the street.
Do as I command!
Yeah. Dude, they gotta make that Starscream holding the Megatron gun toy one day, man.
They did. Yeah, the Masterpiece Edition comes with the little Megatron.
No!
Yes, it does.
And I missed my chance to get it.
Dude, eBay that right shit. Now. Nah, it's really not that bad. It's like $300.
All right.
It's only $300. It's only $300.
Motherfucker, you are not one to complain. You be dropping hundreds of dollars on comic books left and right. And if it weren't for me, your wife would be stringing your ass up by the cock.
Oh, his ass has a cock.
His ass has a cock. Listen, we're not one to judge what Rich does in his own time.
First of all, have I not always been awesome with this
show? No, you have. You've been very good. But every time, I don't know if he just does it to me, but every time we're at conventions and I'm trying to be bad to him and I'm trying to like encourage him to do evil things, like buy comic books, he's always like, yeah, but you know,
I've been spending a lot.
She's gonna divorce me. And I'm like, no, but don't worry about it. She'll understand. What?
He uses me as an excuse?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. Pete's Basement Divorce Court Season 1. It's starting in January.
Wow.
You realize the man who just said $300 for a toy is not that much. So,
did I? You heard me. You guys heard me say Masterpiece Edition, right?
You don't get to have this conversation. conversation when you have Amazing Fantasy fucking 15.
And you got that because of who?
What?
So, what's up with Dragon Age, man? I read this and it seems pretty cool. It's a little like Dungeons and Dragons-y. Yeah. These two people hunt wizards.
Well, you know, Dragon Age, I didn't get to read this, but Dragon Age, it's based off of the video game.
That's exactly
okay, help me out then, because I never played this.
So, I mean,
is this an old school game or?
No, I mean, it's been recent over the last several years. It was out for the 360, PS3. The first two games came out for the 360, PS3. They just came out with, the fuck is the name of the latest one?
Dragon Age Hearth of Fantasy.
For the newest generation systems. I haven't had a chance to play that one yet, but it's all like Dungeons and Dragons based. It's kind of a counterpart to like the Elder Scrolls. This mic is fucking me up. it's kind of like,
In a good or bad way?
I don't know. In a good way for me, because like I've tried out some of the Elder Scrolls games and they are way too expansive and
they're
just too much.
Yeah, way too many hours than I have in the day to be able to devote to playing a game that's really
that's
not that exciting.
That's half the problem, and I'm just to get tangential for a second.
Inquisition, that's what it is.
The Inquisition.
What a show. Inquisition.
Look at sin. We're on a mission to convert the Jews.
What? You never watched fucking History of the
World?
Part 2.
Part one.
No, part two had Jews in space.
We're going to have like the re-education of Ramon at some point. Man. We're just going to clockwork orange. Like this.
We'll even get Malcolm McDowell to show up.
But just to get a little tangential for a second, like I really want a PS4 when Street Fighter V comes out.
Yeah.
That's probably when I'm going to get it. I'm also very interested in the redo of Final Fantasy VII.
But
my ass does not have fucking 120 hours to spare and still be able to read comics for all you guys out there to be able to play this motherfucker.
Did you hear that Final Fantasy VII is going to be released episodically?
Yes, I did.
I just heard that. I'm like, holy shit.
And a lot of people are up in arms about this, and I completely understand
I agree.
Why they would want to do this, because
DLC too. Probably.
Yes, it is. No box DLC. Art, no nothing.
It's always fucking DLC. It's evil.
Yeah.
Listen, I get it. It's going to be a DLC, fucking gigantic game. Yeah.
Do you notice that this week had a bunch of trailers, and then in the middle of all the movie trailers was that Final Fantasy VII trailer, man?
How great did that look, though?
That was great.
Yeah.
Well, except
the best is Leroy. When I was watching
Warcraft, somebody screamed that out.
Did they?
Did they really?
Oh, that's great.
That's great.
I just don't
that's
like
fantastic.
Cloud's outfit with his like little red carpet like cut over here or whatever. I don't know. For some reason, he looked better in the original.
I'm a little upset we didn't get to see the man himself, but you know. Probably in the next couple of trailers.
Yeah, they'll do something like that. But no, Dragon Age, it's fun. It's got a really cool story. You know, fantasy based. So
Mass Effect.
Yeah, it's from the same company that made Mass Effect. So they definitely are good for the story. Gameplay, I don't know how good the gameplay was for this most recent game compared to the other two, but it was solid. It was really good.
This is a fun story. Basically, these two knights-ish or whatever people, and they're out to kill wizards.
Yeah. Sure.
That's all.
Yeah, it's good.
And at one point, some wizard fakes them out into, like, this one squire kind of guy, wizard's assistant or something, tells them that, listen, they're sacrificing children, you have to come and help. And they walk right into a trap.
Right.
So that's the first book.
It's always a
trap, man.
It is what it is. I had some fun with it. I'll probably go. You know, I like all of those.
Yeah, I'm not getting the second one.
I didn't think you would be. Yeah. But like, I'm always into like the Pathfinder books and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Which I loved. I always liked the was it Dragonheart, Dragonfire, something like that. Breath of Fire. I don't know.
That was a great game.
Looking books from back in the day, from like the early 2000s. I can't think of the name of them.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's kind of interesting, and admirable that they want to do comic books based off all the stuff, because they had comic books for Magic the Gathering. They've done books for Halo, Gears of War, like all these other games.
The Witcher, which we loved.
Yeah,
and I've never even played the game.
Eve, Mirror's Edge.
Yeah. Yeah, all that stuff.
Final Fantasy did have some manga, actually.
Did they?
Yeah, but it was like a separate universe, technically.
Yeah, and I mean, other than the story.
How many final fantasies can you possibly fight?
They're never final.
No fantasy is ever final. Yeah, I kind of like that 3D animated film that they did. Not the one with Donald Sutherland. That was a
Advent Children.
Advent Children.
Dude, that's what I want the game to be like.
Action.
That was great.
See, Cloud's costume there was cooler than what it is in Final Fantasy VII right now. Actually,
yeah,
yeah, sure. Yeah. So now we've got Lucifer Volume 2.
Number one.
I didn't read this because I didn't read the
first one. No, the TV show should be based off of this, but this is not Jumping Friendly at all. Okay. I saw the pilot for...
Oh, no way, really?
I saw the pilot for Lucifer.
Yeah, yeah.
That's my first introduction to Lucifer because I never read the Vertigo books.
I didn't read this one. I read all the Mike Carey books before that, actually. It was really good. It was self-contained.
Did you just say Mariah Carey books?
No, Mike Carey.
Mike
Mariah?
Mike Harry?
No, Mike.
Mike Carey.
Mike Carey.
Carey, yeah.
Wow, he should smack his parents. They couldn't have gave him a less alliterative name? It's fucking really? George Carey. George Anthony? Pete. Ramon. Roger. Carey. Roger Carey. Harry Carey would have been fine. They would have assumed he committed suicide every time.
No, that's a doomed name, Pete.
So Mike Carey.
Mike Carey. Sounds like I'm either saying Mike Gary, which is a fucking front kick in Japanese, or Mariah Carey. I mean, I don't think Mariah Carey is in any mental state to be writing books. I'd read.
Glitter, the star of Glitter has not written any comic books yet.
No.
Mike Carey wrote a spinoff from the Neil Gaiman Sandman series, which was about the character Lucifer, right? So in it, Lucifer. Completely just said God fucked up when he created mankind, created Earth and everything. And he said he could do a better job. So he's taking, like, things from Dante's Inferno from the Bible and shit. And so Lucifer in this series does create a separate Earth and a new mankind and everything. And, like, he does try to do what he thinks is better than what God does and everything. Mm-hmm. So it's, like, that's what... It's 10... I think now it's 5 volumes, but it used to be 10 volumes... And it was self-contained. It followed Lucifer's journey into, like, creating mankind, finding it gets corrupted just as easily as God's version of does. But also, we also follow Hell and how Hell, after Lucifer left Hell, how the hierarchy's been, like, reassembled and all these people are fitting into, like, this role and stuff, like, who's now in charge now that Lucifer's gone and everything. Mm-hmm. It's actually really well done, as a matter of fact. Especially for when Sandman was done, when Neil Gaiman finished Sandman, DC was, like, really anxious to, like, find spin-off series, like, really get their, like, that money, like, going and stuff, that attention going and everything. And so they did Dead Boy Detectives, they did all these spin-offs from that series and everything. But that was the one that, like, latched on for a really long time. But it wrapped up really well because Lucifer just kind of just decided, hey, you know, this is the end. I can't really do it. I'm just going to go into eternity or whatever. So I don't see how it got picked up again. I mean, I haven't read number one, though.
Comes back now.
He's back in L.A.
Right.
He's injured.
He had a piano bar in L.A.
No,
actually.
He has a new bar.
A new bar/club.
He's injured. God is dead. Gabriel's a banished drunk.
Uh-huh. Because Gabriel, I think, was running Hell while he was away, actually, and completely screwed it up.
Yeah, see, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So that this is just they give
it's
you.
Not really.
It's not. Oh, man. Which is funny because I'm really looking forward to the series because I like the pilot.
Yeah.
But this book is like
was the pilot self-contained at least essentially like yeah. You came in yeah.
He's just there and yeah. It's just introduced the character and it's gonna build from there.
Hmm. Are you gonna get part two? Like,
I might, because Vertigo, I mean, they will always write good.
Right.
Mm.
I don't know if Vertigo knows how to write wrong.
Honestly, the way the book sounded, I'm kind of, I wish I'd read Volume 1, so I may go back and pick up, a trade of that.
It's a good series, in my opinion. I recommend it for most people. It's like, if you read Sandman, you definitely should read Lucifer if you're looking for more.
Okay.
If you haven't read Sandman, I think you could still appreciate it. The thing is, I don't know if they mentioned some of both this book or the TV show, but there was a spin-off character who's this dude who's consigned to hell because of how he, I think, killed his girlfriend after she cheated on him, or wife after she cheated on him.
She probably deserved it.
And this dude rises the ranks from being this tortured soul in hell to becoming like a lord in hell.
They haven't shown them yet, the lords of hell.
That guy was much more interesting than like Lucifer had like a straightforward story, but this dude was like the interesting guy that took over the narrative actually in the original series.
Hmm.
Yeah.
See, that sounds interesting.
It was like a Game of Thrones type thing.
Not yet.
Inside of hell.
So, did anybody read Judge Dredd
yes.
this week? What'd you think?
Yeah.
What was it, Judge Dredd this week? Was it like...
It's a new one.
He's in
one.
Like...
From IDW though? Yeah. Or from, okay.
Yeah, it's IDW. He gets like transported... You don't realize it until the end of the book, and I'm going to try not to spoil this, but it's just not fucking worth it. He doesn't realize it until the very end that he's in a far-flung future where Mega City 1 is now just an overgrown...
Or a like, parallel world.
Or a parallel world.
They've done it before.
Where Mega City 1 is just like an overgrown wasteland. Like, nature has taken back everything.
But that's the thing. It's the wasteland has starting to produce vegetation. So it's not the typical wasteland we're used to.
Right. Because it's so only it's, radiation.
And he has no idea how he got there or anything. He's, you know, trying to remember shit. Yeah. And there's like these little kids that are beating the shit out of this homeless guy who was apparently kicking puppies
or
something.
And they speak weird, which is always irritates me when it comes to like books based in the future, the lingo and shit like that.
Right.
This was a struggle for me.
You know, who started this, right? H.G. Wells, man, when he created the Morlocks and the Elots, man, they just spoke funny. Oh, the Morlocks didn't speak at all, but the Elots, like, the idea that people have, like, different...
Can languages. I just say, like, in this day and age, could you imagine if somebody attempted that H.G. Wells shit? Like, how he would be tried for war crimes against society for pulling a stunt like that? Like, could you, like, just imagine... All right, back in the day, like, everybody's internet was just radio.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
People were susceptible and far more gullible than they are today.
Oh, right.
I mean, Abraham Lincoln was the first one to say you can't trust the internet.
Right.
So, if you actually managed to put together... If you put together a stunt so elaborate in this day and age that you fooled the internet, the TV, and the radio...
I think
it was all a hoax.
Pete, yeah. Without showing any political bias,
you'd be burned at the stake. Live television.
I think Donald Trump is doing that by saying that Muslims are suddenly invading like Martians on Earth right now, actually, I think.
And also, the Russians try to do that on a regular basis.
Oh, is that right?
If you know that, but the Russians have, they have very carefully tried to create fake personas that, like, will follow you and interact with you on social media to a certain point where they have actually tried to do this, where they all of a sudden like tried to plant this idea through these fake accounts that something was happening, some news thing was happening. And actually it didn't work because people were so smart. You're so used to bots.
Like search anything else essentially.
Well, and they realized used to like fake accounts on Twitter and stuff that you're just like, okay, whatever, this guy's fake. I can tell he's fake.
So
And Peach Basement Land out there, just so you all know, by Russians, Roger actually means like the Koreans. not the Russians, for sure. Definitely not the Russians, Roger. Not the fucking Russians. Their leader wrestles
that
bears with judo, and ours plays golf. So let's just, you know, weigh the options here.
And basketball.
By the way, I read that on the internet.
Well, of course he plays basketball. That was a bit racist. I'm sorry. That was.
Everybody's a little
racist.
Every single president before him played golf too.
No,
so.
It's prejudice. It's funnier.
Prejudice is funnier. You know what the bitch about stereotypes is, right?
What?
They're all fucking true.
Yeah.
At least at some capacity.
Well, speaking as an Italian from Brooklyn, I know plenty of dudes who are not but 5'5", can bench press 350 pounds, have absolutely no neck to speak of. It's just trapezoid and skull.
And gold chain.
Gold chains, Cuban link only, mind you. Will still cry if their mother smacks them. In fucking public, mom will hit them.
Has enough hair gel to grease an engine.
Absolutely.
I know Greeks own diners.
Can I just, do you want to know the secret, by the way? It's not hair gel anymore.
Oh,
it's
no.
It's a leave-in conditioner. Spray-on leave-in conditioner, folks. It's beautiful.
Okay, have you seen my afro?
Yes, I have.
Yeah. Oh, bring it out, bro.
By the way, guys, just so you know that when we're talking to the studio audience here, we're actually talking to Rich and Trish and Roger. Guys, come over and say hello at least so everybody knows who the fuck we're talking to.
Yeah, walk by.
We don't have enough microphones or a sizable table to accommodate everyone.
It's Christmas.
So that's why they're here waiting to film a spoiler-ridden review of Star Wars.
Yep.
Which
yep,
we will
yep.
get to later on in the night.
Drag out fight with Pete and Pete.
Oh, yeah.
Star Wars.
Woo. But before we do, let's answer a question from our boy David Peralta. Or how did you say that last
this
time?
This is from David Peralta.
Peralta?
Yeah. Peralta.
Did I get that right?
Yeah.
Did I roll my R properly?
Nope.
You don't need to roll your R's. It's just single R.
Peralta.
It's a double R. They're supposed to roll it.
Peralta.
Okay.
Peralta.
Yeah.
Peralta.
I said, what are the chances of Wolverine coming back to the Marvel Universe instead of Old Man Logan? And if so, do you believe X-23 should go back to wearing her X-Force costume? I think it's sexy. Do y'all think so, too? If not, which is your favorite costume of hers?
Oh, boy.
Well, the X-Force costume.
The X-Force costume is off the hook. The black, the gray, the half shirt.
But it was the best for everybody.
Belly shirt, yeah.
Yeah.
I was always a fan of belly shirts. I was back in the 90s. I was happy to see a resurgence of these things back
in,
over
chicks,
this
so
summer.
Not on guys, because there were not way too many guys in the 90s who wore that shit.
No,
like,
in the 80s,
fuck?
Man. The late 80s, yeah, that shit happened with the mesh and everything.
Yeah.
Wait until the hipsters bring it back.
No, they'll never do that, I don't think.
Listen, this still... They're only just now getting PBR back into the mainstream spotlight. It's gonna take a while.
I would like to see Wolverine come back.
He's coming back, but it's gonna be a while.
Do you think it'll be... Now, here's my question. Do you think it'll be like some sort of... you know, somebody gets him out of the adamantium shell? Or do you think it'll be some sort of de-aging process for Old Man Logan, who just turns back into regular
Wolverine?
That'd
be shit.
I would go de-aging.
Marvel is dumb enough to do that and think that it would go over.
I would prefer
getting him out of the adamantium.
So would everybody else with a brain in their head.
But not making him weld in the first two issues.
You know,
like drag out his healing because he's literally coming from death.
What I think it is you know how like Pixar took the comic Big Hero 6 and made it into a movie? Mm-hmm. So now like Disney and Marvel's like merging more and more together. I think... somebody in the X-Men, let's say Beast, will come across a magic lamp, the exact lamp from Aladdin, and wish that Wolverine comes back, and the Robin Williams genie will come back and bring
him
back.
He actually had me for 5 seconds. He had me.
Here's what I think.
And then he lost.
If I were writing it, because you're half right. He's not coming back from death. He's alive in that adamantium shell.
He shouldn't be, because he lost his healing powers.
Until they magically came back because of no more mutants or the Terrigen Mists bring his healing factor back suddenly.
He's a mutant / inhuman.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, God.
Now they've been excuse to bring him into Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
See, if they just magically bring back his healing factor or write something where, you know, they figure the fans will forget that he didn't have a healing factor anymore, because I forgot. I really did. You're coming out of... years upon years of solitary confinement, just not being able to move a single inch.
Oh no, we're
he's
gonna get
crazy.
Back bandana Wolverine.
Let him be a fucking feral
we're gonna get
psychopath.
Wolverine again,
yeah,
with a bandana over his face.
But I would accept that. Let him be a fucking lunatic.
I'll be alright with that.
Yeah.
As straight males, right?
Last I checked.
Who's the most attractive guy that you guys will accept as an attractive man?
In real life or like comic books?
Whatever, real life or comic books. Pick one.
Sean Connery.
No, it's good.
I hope I look that good when I'm 80.
You got one? Cheeseburger?
This is weird.
Mine's Ryan Gosling. Who are you?
I'm a little confused.
Ryan Gosling, really?
Yeah, I think he's actually.
All right. Brad Pitt, Legend of the Falls, Brad Pitt, though.
Okay, that's a good one.
I think you just got Pat's Twibby running.
I agree with you with Sean Connery too, my love.
Thank you.
He did age well.
Yes, I know.
But Legend of the Fall, Brad Pitt's like...
Really?
All right.
Ryan Gosling can go in the...
Honestly, I think Joe Manganiello sets the bar entirely too high for regular dudes.
Well, yeah, thank you.
No, he's unfair. Then he married Sophia Vergara. Yeah,
Joe Manganiello.
What the fuck? Their kids are going to like, come on, training.
Yeah.
All right. Here's
about Shining?
He has actually taken over as like the ambassador for fitness, according to Arnold Schwarzenegger, who is one of his idols, and has passed the torch to Joe Manganiello.
That's pretty cool.
Which is fucking awesome.
Here's my theory.
I'll go with him.
Here's my theory about X-23.
Nobody said Joe Pesci.
Yeah, Joe Pesci is a...
That Joe Pesci, guys, is Roger's answer to pretty much everything.
Wait a minute. First of all, we're on a dorky TV show. Why isn't anybody says Patrick Stewart?
Because Patrick Stewart is not...
Because Patrick Stewart's bald. Hello?
Bald.
If I lose this, what do I have?
He can talk, and I would fucking.
Guys, stay tuned, by the way, for later on when I get more drunk and then cut a giant block of cheese with a samurai sword. Can we show the block of cheese,
show
please?
Show the block of cheese.
That's the cheese. Oh, Jesus.
And we can thank Alyssa for this. Alyssa Face is in the house.
Cheese.
We are actually going to cut the cheese on live television. This, folks, please have your cell phones ready to dial 911 just in case.
We'll do this as a separate Periscope. And it's gonna be drunk Italian guy with samurai. Share the fuck out of that.
Alright. Here's why I asked this question to you guys. If they cloned Sean Connery, but they only found his X chromosomes and made a female younger Sean Connery, or a female younger, wait, who'd you say? Brad Pitt, or a female younger. Sophia Vergara, that one, whatever.
Or, these questions are getting Sophia weirder, Vergara. Dimitrios. Just
yeah,
so you know.
I'm saying, would you feel less ashamed about being attracted to, like...
I'm not ashamed by it. I'm a perfectly heterosexual man. I love tits, don't get me wrong.
Right.
I am cool comfortable enough to let you know when a dude is attractive or not. Which is why,
female Sean Connery, dude. That's what X-23.
If you're asking me if I'm cool
Wolverine.
With a young Scottish girl, absolutely. Right.
Sure.
Finally, a Scot that doesn't need to wear underwear under that kilt. Thank you.
Watching Doctor Who and what's her name is Scottish.
She's Scottish. She's so hot. Karen
Gillan. She's X-23, dude. She's X-23. Karen Gillan X-23 in the movie. She should be at least.
I think I have a different actress in mind for her, but I'll get back to you on that.
Okay.
I'll make up a post of some kind with that.
I'm not familiar with the show, so I have to see what she looks like to make a judgment call.
Karen Gillan was Nebula.
Yeah.
Oh, Nebula, yeah, totally. Bro. Okay, I don't know what she looks like normally
without,
outside
like,
of the makeup.
Know, blue ball without, machinery.
Yeah, and like a semi-twisted arm that she's just like, I'm like, what the
X-23 would do that, man, because she heals.
What's up with Cops for Criminals, bro?
Cops of Criminals actually came out a few weeks ago. I just didn't get to read it until this week.
Okay.
This is FBI agent who just goes to undercover and he gets screwed over.
Roger, can I top
That's
you
really
off there?
It. It's just...
Come on over. Say hello to the fans for Christmas.
It's... I mean, my thing is legendary...
Show your sexy face and chest hair.
Legendary usually does stuff that's going to be made into movies.
Yeah.
I can't see this being made into movies.
You know, lean down. Why? You know to lean down.
It's
say
a
hello.
Cop being framed.
Yeah. Show some chest hair.
It's like so easy to make into a movie, though.
Yeah, it's but it's been Joe done.
Oh, it's like
yeah,
too
it's,
easy.
Yeah.
A younger female clone of Joe Pesci's.
Oh, God.
Oh, man.
And the art's only okay.
Can you imagine it's a younger female version of Joe Pesci saying two youths?
The two youths.
A female Joe Pesci.
Yeah.
Female Joe Pesci, man.
I think the universe would break in half.
Roger, would you fuck a female Joe Pesci?
Am I a clown to you?
Wouldn't that be snooky?
I think that's kind of my destiny.
Oh, yeah.
What did you say?
Wouldn't that be snooky?
Snooky's cute.
Or God forbid.
Like in a fuckable type of sense, you know?
I would have fucked her.
I would have fucked her. Yeah.
Have you seen her now that she lost all the weight? She looks like a freak.
Snooky's
weird.
She looks like a crack addict now.
Funny?
Oh, wow, maybe she lost more weight than I thought she did.
Nah, she looks terrible now. She was so much better chubby
now?
With big tits.
No, I like the chubby with big tits.
Me too.
Snooki, eat something.
Eat something.
Fucking for real.
Eat some
Go back
pasta.
To Garfield weight.
And then eat something more.
Eat something. And then eat something else.
Go back to Garfield weight.
Who loves you, baby? Who loves you? So, before we get into Marvel, we got one more. Locust Moon... Prometheus Eternal sucked.
What was that?
Oh my, it was like a bunch of different writers and artists doing their take on the old ancient Greek story.
Prometheus. The one with the vulture
guy
eats
gets
the gut and
eats
he's
his
tortured.
Liver. Yeah.
So different stories about that one
man. Yeah, like 2 to 3 pages max. One of them was Morrison. The best one was the last one who I forgot by.
What did Morrison do for that?
Oh,
some
weird
stupid
shit.
Shit.
He's like a superhero
Batman
and
Damian.
This was so difficult for me to get through.
Really?
I read the
I thought
entire...
as an artist you would appreciate it more.
I couldn't fucking stand it.
Each of them have different, like, totally different drawing styles.
Couldn't fucking stand it. I
it was one myth and several stories? That's really unique to me that this is just one story.
I think
story.
You like it.
I wanted to like it. I really did, and it just—I couldn't
get
into it.
How can you come up with an original story in 3 pages? That's hard.
They were did like it's just one of the books quick. Was one of the stories rather was this one particular artist who found out about the myth and he saw Michelangelo's work on the myth and he saw Titian's work on the myth. I forget what the second artist's name was.
Oh yeah, it's almost thing. Like a biography about how the artist got to
and how he decided to. He was inspired really to make his own. I forget what this guy's name was.
Prometheus, famous painting.
1600s or so, like right after Michelangelo and Titian.
Something Rubin.
Peter Paul Rubin.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Pee Wee Herman guy. Right.
Paul Rubens.
Oh my yes.
God. It's Quantum Theater.
The Rock is a Death Star and the guy is
painting on Prometheus.
Huh? I just couldn't get into it. I wanted to, but so guys, before we continue, we have one more question from David Peralta. Said, did you guys hear about the announcement Marvel made about Moon Knight coming to Netflix? If so, what do you think?
We announced
I got news for you, David. We told you about that a long time ago, back in probably mid-September, when we first heard about
Moon Knight, Spider-Woman, Deathlock, and Punisher.
Well, we knew Punisher was coming for a while.
Yep. No, but we just known about it.
Moon Knight has been so hard hinted at. We already know it's coming, but we can only say it's a rumor. But trust us, it's fucking coming. Have we lied to you yet? No. And the amount of times we've been wrong is like 1 out of 100. We were wrong once. And that was only because fucking, what's his name? Berlando.
You fuck with us. Yeah, that would fuck with us.
He didn't manage to get the Flash crossover done with Supergirl. Supergirl was slated for 22 episodes. They only backed 20. The last two were supposed to be Flash, and Maxwell Lord was supposed to turn out to be Brainiac. But
Moon Knight
you don't
should
know
be
that.
HBO.
Wait, did you say slated as a pun for what's her name, Kelly Slater?
I would watch that if it was on HBO.
Oh, okay.
But if it's gonna be on Netflix, it should be
Helen Slater.
It could be
Helen
Slater. Right?
Helen Slater. Helen Slater.
Could be what?
It could be like you know something that. Was like
I forgot to mention. I've been watching your show for 5 years.
Netflix could do HBO. Oh.
Hang on, guys. David said, I forgot to mention, I've been watching your show for 5 years. You guys are the best. Thank you, sir. Thank you for the compliment. You need your head examined.
You guys are the best. No, you are the best.
And thanks for recommending East of West. Great story. Yes, it is. It's still a fun story. That's still going, actually.
It is.
I'm assuming it's an ongoing or it's going to be a maxi. I don't know where that's going to end, but we'll talk about it when it does end. What do you guys think of the relationship between X-23 and Young Angel?
I hate
everything about
like
the
it.
New X-Men being
Why?
The old new X-Men.
Oh, I hate that. I hate that altogether. But if that's a fact of life,
like then I have to just swallow it and fucking deal with it.
No, if you swallow it, X-23, the Angel works well. I think
can't fucking deal with it, bro.
What I can't stand is that she went from being a fucking master assassin, brutal,
to
she went to being a fucking prostitute.
Yeah.
People don't tell me they Batgirled her.
They're pretty much Batgirling
her. Batgirled her, yeah.
And now she's like happy-go-lucky with her flying boyfriend.
Yeah.
Who's supposed to come back as Darth, what's his name? Archangel.
Archangel.
Next
Darth Angel?
No. Yeah. There's still two angels though, right? There's still that dude and the other dude, right?
No, there's just...
What happened to the aged Archangel? He's not around anymore with the... From Wolverine the X-Men? I think he's still around, dude.
Is he?
Yeah, I think that's when he's going to become Archangel again.
So before we get to the Marvel comics and the last questions of the show, in this bag of what used to hold cookies, Roger brought some cookies for the holidays. And by the way, the thing kind of looks like me when I wear my glasses.
Yeah.
You wear glasses, bro?
I do wear glasses sometimes when I want to see, but I find the world looks better blurry.
Yeah, I agree.
Especially when you're hitting on women.
Why do you think he drinks?
Yeah. So... I have in this bag a whole bunch of names from everybody that entered the Star Wars bank contest. Being that there are four banks and conveniently four of us at the table, I think it's proper that each one of us draw a name. So I will go first. The first contest will be for the Darth Vader bank. Right here, he's got his lightsaber on the back there. You just hook it up. So here we go. Let's open the bag. Aha. And the first winner is Geektastic Dad, which is one of the coolest Instagram names I've ever heard.
Yeah,
Geektastic
awesome.
Dad, congratulations. I'm not sure if you're going to give this to your son or daughter or keep it for yourself, but either one I think is fantastic.
Geektastic Dad isn't a dad, actually.
No?
He's just a guy who
pick that as a name.
Well, the internet doesn't lie, man.
Can I pick one?
I was going to let Ramon go
for
first.
For the B. Arthur, I want to do one.
You can do B. Arthur. Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
B. Arthur.
All right. For Darth Golden Girls.
Darth Golden Girls.
So bad.
I got Data Comics.
Beta Comics.
Beta Comics.
Beta underscore comics. Beta underscore comics.
You won. Darth Maul B. Arthur, son. You got it. Mad B. Arthur. Great.
So, yeah. Let's go with the Stormtrooper. Go ahead, Cheese.
All right. Stormtrooper goes to That Damn Art Page.
Ooh.
Congratulations. To That Damn Art Page, you win the Stormtrooper. I am a
Stormtrooper. That's actually, that's a damn good art page. Just want to say that. We followed them ourselves.
I see what you did there.
Would that be the same height?
Fuck do I know, man? I didn't design the shit.
He was cut off below the.
And now we've got the last one, Boba Fett.
The best one, man. He's coming back in the.
Let's go to Ramon.
Right?
He's supposed to be coming back. I hope he's coming back.
He's supposed to be, yeah.
Oh, that's whack.
Listen, I'll tell you why it's not whack in a moment.
Sarlacc paper.
Funko Show and Tell.
Funko Show and Tell. You won the Boba Fett bank. Congratulations to our four winners. Thank you, everybody, for entering. Everybody that does enter, that did enter, however, will receive a cool comic from the Pete's Basement show. So everybody, please send us your addresses and we will mail you off a free
everybody
comic
who entered.
Of our choosing. Everybody
entered.
Who entered.
Entered.
Didn't I say that?
No, you said everybody.
Oh,
everybody.
Well, everybody that entered. And I know who you are because I liked all your posts. So no fair like posting the shit now. Everybody who entered will get a free comic book of our choosing, and we will send it off to you. So please send us your addresses.
6 to 8 weeks.
Under normal circumstances.
No, it's actually longer now, right?
What?
Because of holidays?
About 8 to 10 weeks, give or take. Yeah. I know I still owe a couple of you some t-shirts from our NYCC giveaway. I have not forgotten you. Don't worry. I'm still waiting on a t-shirt order to come in the mail. When I get them, you'll get them. So don't worry. I don't forget.
I entered. I'm fresh underscore one on Instagram. Sorry, Adrella, you didn't win.
It's all right, brother. But send us your address. Email it to us at questions@peachbasement.com.
Something.
And we'll send you off something cool. Don't worry. We always hook up our fans. It's what we
Jason
do.
Jason Hagopian. So 24 to 48 weeks then.
Yeah, give or take. About a year. Under normal circumstances, guys, we would have hooked you up with a free month subscription to the Pete's Basement show. But come the new year, we don't want you guys subscribing to Pivot Share anymore. Okay? Listen, we're dropping Pivot Share. We've got something new in mind, which we will tell you about the very first episode of 2016, okay? So, if you have subscribed, thank you for all your support. You guys are wonderful. Pete's Basement has the best fans in the whole fucking world. I'm going to tell you that right now because you're the realest motherfuckers out there.
Absolutely.
Unlike all of those other podcasts out there.
Absolutely.
Except for all of our friends, all of the other guys that take this shit way too fucking seriously.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah.
There are some people that just be like this is life and death. Us.
Yeah. Or they're full of shit.
Or
they're bougie.
Yeah.
Or both.
Yeah. Or both.
We know who our friends are, Comical Podcast, Epic Comic Cast, all you guys that helped us out with the NYCC contest. I know there was about 8 to 10 of you whose names are slipping my mind at the time, but we do not forget you guys. I have a bad memory, but I have all of you guys written down and we don't forget you. But as for you fans out there who did subscribe, thank you for all your support over the course of this year and the last. Do not subscribe come the new year. Let that subscription fade, and we have something brand new coming in 2016, so look forward to that. And if you are still subscribed in the month of December, we're going to hook you up with something else too. So let us know if you are still subscribing. Hit us up again, questions@petesbasement.com. Roger will let me know if you're subscribed, and I will hook you guys up for all of your fucking support, because, like I said, you guys are the best, and we owe everything to you guys. Like, this whole thing would never happen if it weren't for all of yous. So the least we could do is hook you guys up the way you've helped us. And that's what we
here,
do.
Here, here. Woo!
Cheers.
Cheers.
Vegetable Tube wants to know if you're on Midtown's podcast.
Occasionally. I like the Midtown Comics podcast, but they don't let me curse or drink as much as they do here. In fact, when I drink...
You usually have to say it's soda?
They don't know that I'm drinking, and when I curse, they usually cut it out, actually. So
I like fuck that shit.
But this is the podcast I prefer, guys.
Those thank you, bastards. Sir. So, let's talk Marvel.
Do we have to?
No, actually, I'm going to save the best one for last.
I want to.
We're going
to
talk Weirdworld first.
This was weird.
Yeah, kind of goes without saying.
It was weird.
Yeah.
It was. I don't like know this,
there's some big like butch.
This is a serious chick. Bad trip. It's a serious bad trip.
A Ferrari
with a Hemi.
Yeah.
You know.
Some sort of blower on the top with a skull on it, like a cow skull or some shit.
Yeah.
This is like, a weird book, man.
This is fucking weird.
I don't know where they're gonna go with this.
Crazy as it is, as weird as the story.
You liked
it. It gets dark like towards the end, which okay. Like I'll buy it for a dollar.
It's another wizard killing book.
It's another wizard killing book. I don't know what Marvel has against wizards. Or even the comic world in general.
No, last one was Dark Horse. Last one was Dark Horse that was killing wizards.
Okay, well,
yeah, they don't want to kill
the comic world in general.
Though.
Exactly. Like,
he's
what's the deal with killing wizards?
Oh, he's supposed to be not a wizard, right?
Some wizards are good. I mean, look at
Gandalf.
Yeah. Look at Dumbledore. You know, Doctor Strange. Mm-hmm.
The first Dumbledore, not the second Dumbledore.
Here's my whole question.
Either one.
No.
Is there a point to Weirdworld?
Listen, Michael Gambon did a great job after Richard Harris died.
Good job.
I got a question for you guys. Is there a point to? Do you think there's a point to Weirdworld since there's Black Knight out, which is about a dude who's stranded on Weirdworld, also like a more
relatable
dude?
That is a good question.
It's a thing, like.
I love if they do something like that, I think that would be kind of cool.
Were you a fan of the Weirdworld book like back in the 70s and 80s when it was?
I never read that actually. I honestly didn't even know that was a big thing, honestly.
No.
Vegetable said he likes Shield's Division of Magic. I didn't know they had a Division of Magic.
Yeah. Is that like in the current Shield book? Because I'm very behind on Shield.
I am horribly behind the Shield.
Yeah.
I was enjoying that book though, not for nothing.
I don't think you need a Division of Magic. I think that's like kind of like. I think the government being able to classify a division of magic kind of defeats the purpose of magic existing to begin with, actually. You know what I mean?
In a way, sure. I mean, to what you said, I mean, I like the artwork on the book. The artwork on the book was really good.
Yeah.
It was really good. And you were like, to be able to articulate the fact that the book, the storyline, looks like you're in the middle of a bad trip and make it effective.
Yeah.
That's some tough shit. Mm. That's tough to pull
I'm
off.
I'm sitting there like, I'm reading it and I'm struggling to get through it. I'm like, all right, this girl's killing weird Muppet Sesame Street looking wizards.
Well, like, actually, the one that she did kill looked like it was pulled out of the animation from Samurai Jack.
I never watched that show.
That show's
cool. But that show's coming back.
I heard about that. I heard about that and I can't fucking wait.
Comic
awesome. You guys ever read Steve Rude's Nexus by any chance?
No.
Ooh, okay.
Oh, Adam loved that.
Dude. Okay, I think for any experienced comic fan, you guys have to just get into a little bit of the world of Nexus. That's it. You don't have to, like, read them all. There's a lot of books out there. But the whole thing is about this guy who's super powerful. Like, he's powerful Superman or whatever. And he gets these visions where he's supposed to kill specific, like, dictators or just specific people who are, whatever, destroying the galaxy.
Okay.
Not any... dictator, just regular, like, your, you know, whatever, Darth Vader or Darth Mauls or whatever, right? He just goes and kills those guys, right? But he starts to, like, have a question, why those people, why not other people who are even worse or whatever. Anyway, it's really good. But what I really like about it is that the Steve Rude, his entire alien landscape. Anytime you see like non-human aliens, they look like Muppets. Also, they look like Vincent, create like little like Farscape type characters and shit. So okay. That's what you guys are telling me. Like that's what it's reminding me of, actually.
I loved the artwork. It was a total bad trip.
Yeah,
you know,
girls like.
Half.
Oh my God, there's Earth. I have to get back to Mexico to bury my fucking mom's ashes. Like, I'm like, whoa,
yeah, that was when it got
out of
dark.
Nowhere.
Yeah, completely out of left field. And then they show, you know, what happened to her mother. And
who,
like,
committed fucking suicide with pills, man, and alcohol.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Spoiler
alert. Gotta bury her, bro.
Yeah, spoiler alert. Whoopsie.
I'm editing. The cheese will go down there beforehand. Don't worry.
That cheese or the graphic cheese?
Ooh, that would be good. Too bad. We didn't think of it beforehand. Real cheese ready for the spoilers.
Yeah.
That is true.
Wait, so is Weirdworld looking like it's going to be like an anthology of like about different characters and stuff, or is it looking like
at this point it looks like it's going to follow these people?
Yeah,
I can't speak for, you know, 3 or 4 issues down the line.
Right,
but whatever.
Yeah, yeah, like, you know, like Pete said, Red Sonja, like a Butch type Red Sonja type character driving a hot rod.
Nice.
Basically, that's her steed.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, cleaving wizards in half. You know, sounds like it's going to be a fun, it could be a fun ride.
I guess it's another issue too, right?
But yeah, I guess you'll find out for issue two. But it looks like it's going to focus on this Earth girl who we still don't know how the hell she got there. So that's going to be an interesting,
right?
That could be an interesting.
Black Knight's on that world, man.
You read it and let me know, because
I guess.
Done with it.
I'll have to.
He's done.
What's up with Starbrand and Nightmask?
Garbage.
Bitch.
They bad-girled them hard.
Hold on. Do you know
they're in college, bro. With Squirrel Girl.
That's fine.
With Squirrel Girl.
Do you know who's writing that series?
You heard me say Squirrel Girl.
Yeah, that's fine. Squirrel Girl has her own fan base.
It's not.
Do you know who's writing that series?
Who?
Greg Weisman, the creator of your, I'm sure it's your favorite cartoon series in that time period, Gargoyles, man. The creator of Gargoyles is writing that series, man.
My problem with this, and why I think
then
it sucks.
He's on Prozac.
They go from being like serious mega cosmic. Not like regular cosmic.
Yeah, they are mega cosmic.
Like crazy,
like Silver Surfer level cosmic.
And now they're in fucking college.
Because you have to get back in touch with your human side.
All right. Let me give you guys a little bit of history.
I didn't like these two assholes when they first appeared in the Avengers books.
I don't like how they were introduced to us. It was almost like they pushed them on.
They certainly did.
All right. Let me give you guys ready for a history lesson?
Sure.
Is everyone out there ready for a history
is
lesson?
This back when Marvel sanctioned off that like little DVD?
New Universe.
New
Universe.
Uh-huh.
I am going to give you that lesson. You ready for it?
Sure.
Clench.
Wait.
Give me that lesson.
Wait.
Trish is ready to pass.
Go ahead.
In 1986, Marvel's 25th anniversary since debut of Marvel, since debut of Fantastic Four, they, with Jim Shooter's guidance, debuted the New Universe, right? So the New Universe launched 8 titles simultaneously. And the idea was that when Marvel debuted, they gave you some realistic comics. Like Peter Parker was this guy who was a loser in high school who had superpowers. They debuted Hulk, who was this nerd who ended up having, like, fucking Jekyll and Hyde complex and stuff, right? Much more grounded than gods from DC and everything, right? So Jim Shooter wanted to take it to the next level. It was the world outside your window up until 1986. It was America with the communist threat at that point. Starbrand debuts, and Ken Kernel is this guy who suddenly gets the Starbrand, which gives him Superman-level powers. Nightmask is Keith Remsen, who suddenly, after the white event, this blanketing white, like, sky event, gives him the power to enter other people's dreams and stuff, right? So that, among other stuff, is just properties that Marvel is, like, just, they have. They haven't used them. They haven't done anything with them. Fucking Mark Grunwald debuted him in Quasar briefly for a little while and stuff. They brought him back with Exiles. I think Tony Bedard did that. And now, what's his name? Hickman. Hickman brings him to the Avengers stuff and says, okay, there's a white event all over in every universe and everything. And, you know, and so why can't the Marvel Universe have a Starbrand? Why can't the Marvel Universe have a Nightmask and everything, right? And this is fresh after Warren Ellis's attempt to reboot the new universe.
Explain that to the
So you have these properties. Why not make them college students?
No!
That's where I am right now.
We last saw them
Oh my God!
Not that long ago.
Buzzkill than Buzz Killington.
Smells like
A, and now we got it in B.
Guys, I ghettoed my own lightsaber out of a.
No, you didn't even. You didn't even ghetto it. You ghetto half-assed it.
Seriously,
it was a wrapping paper roll that I spray painted.
You lazy motherfucker!
I wish I had red. I didn't. I had blue.
Aha, you're not a Sith.
Wait, did I just get executed by a rolling paper?
I'd like to think that only the part of you that was talking about this Marvel story got executed.
I think you executed yourself a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
Oh, man.
1986. Very well put. Welcome back, though.
Thank you. I'm now a ghost. You can't kill. I'm more powerful than ever. With more
than
Marvel
you can find more powerful and than you can possibly imagine. Like,
now that I've got you, let me tell you a story about a bridge.
So, last but not least, we've got Squadron Supreme.
Oh, man.
Which picked up sort of right after the
Avengers
Squadron
Zero?
Sinister.
No.
Not really.
Avengers Number Zero, really.
Yeah.
Because
although it had the same totally characters, they weren't the evil bastards.
It didn't have the same
Squadron
characters.
Supreme.
Out of the entire book, I really did.
But this is Black Nighthawk.
That's right. Black Nighthawk. That's racist Nighthawk from J. Michael Straczynski's from Supreme Power.
That was a good book, though.
That was a good book, except they had no ending.
JMS.
No, okay, the first couple of books were good. Yeah, it kind of rambled on for a while. This is Squadron Supreme from different multiverses.
Yeah, huh?
Yeah.
Which is awesome and interesting. And like, ooh.
Why are they so pissed at Namor, yo?
Because Namor went crazy killing other multiverses.
Because when he was in the Cabal, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they remember all of that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And payback's a bitch.
Yeah. Payback
it was
is
such
a bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about what they do. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler.
Spoiler.
But it's not really a spoiler.
It's because not, wait somebody a announced this.
Because this shit got dropped on Newsarama fucking months ago.
Correct.
That's bullshit.
Correct.
You can't even be surprised at nothing that happens in comics no more.
Nah.
People always wonder, like, yo, did you hear about that? And I'm like, no.
You see the cover issue,
because I stay away from fucking Solicit.
You see the cover issue, too?
Yeah, he's holding his fucking head in his hand.
Yeah.
Spoiler, if I insist on putting the cheese
spoiler,
down there.
Hyperion decapitates Namor.
With heat vision.
Yes.
But, like, I can't even imagine why that needs to be the cover issue two. If you already decapitated him, why is that the plot of issue number two holding
and
the head?
Why is his eye still open?
Because he's shocked that Hyperion had heat vision, I guess.
This dude...
Oh, weren't we all?
This dude Namor... Hold on. First of all, this dude Namor survived being dropped on a planet that was blown up after being stabbed by... a dagger from Black Panther that was imbued by the spirits of his ancestors.
So he's basically like the comic book Rasputin.
And so, yeah. and to believe that a decapitation from heat vision would kill him, I don't believe that actually, personally.
Yeah, it
Wait,
was
think
weak.
The head's gonna live by
they,
itself?
They could have killed somebody
I
else.
Think, I mean, the dude got blown
got played,
up
yo.
On a planet.
Yeah, played, yeah.
And stabbed by a dagger. I've been stabbed by daggers, but not by daggers with ancestral spirits on them.
You've been stabbed by
well,
daggers?
Well, apparently, well, you know
that's
what?
A that's a story, Ramon. That's
actually, apparently
story
those ancestral spirits was what they told T'Challa was on the internet.
So. No, but his own spirits told him that, man.
Stand
he
T'Challa,
visited
man.
His
it's
father
just Chala,
and other spirits.
Right. It's the T is silent.
So why haven't
T'Challa.
I don't know.
Fucker.
Ask fucking Dikembe Mutombo why his name is spelled that way.
Dikembe Mutombo.
I can't
stand him.
No.
Dikembe Tumbo.
I can't stand him, Black Panther.
What?
I can't.
Not in my house.
Black character in comics, you can't stand him?
Yeah, and they gave him wealth. They gave him a fucking country. They gave him super intelligence. They gave him a special badass suit with vibranium.
The
they gave him enhanced powers.
Who's the second
what the
black
fuck?
Character
overcompensating much. Why don't you just give him Titan, a dick that reaches his calf or some shit? But it's too fucking much.
No, he does have a dick that long. But who's the second black character in comics, you know?
Luke Cage?
It's not Luke Cage?
No. Well, Luke Cage way later. Bill Foster, who became Black Goliath, actually. He debuted...
Did he die?
Yeah, he did die. He did
killed.
Die. He died in Civil War, actually.
And no one cared.
He debuted he debuted 2 months after T'Challa. And I love this comic. It was... I forgot what issue of Avengers it was, but Hank Pym was looking for an assistant for his laboratory. And it's, to me, the most progressive and not progressive comic in history. Because when he's looking for an assistant for his laboratory, and Wasp, Jenny Van Dyne, says, why can't I be your assistant in the laboratory? You know, I've done it before. He goes, no, You should go back to shopping, which is what you're good at, honey.
Oh, that's great.
Wow, that's funny.
So he tells the woman she can't be a lab assistant, but then he hires the second black man in comics to be his lab assistant because he says, you're very qualified to be my lab assistant. He hires him, man. So he puts that woman and hires a black man. I love that issue, man, because it's just most progressive.
What issue was that?
It was like 39, something like that. Most progressive.
It should be noted that black men received the right to vote before women did. Just, yep. You know, history.
Is that right?
Yes, that is true.
Yep.
Oh, man.
Cool. Don't ask me what year or anything. Like, I come on, I remember a little bit, but I mean, not a lot.
Okay.
But nevertheless, I enjoyed Squadron Supreme.
Yeah, and that was pretty cool.
Back for more.
I did
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna say one thing about Squadron Supreme.
Okay.
This is definitely my favorite book of the week. The fact that Alex Ross did the cover is no mistake. Alex Ross did the cover for the original miniseries graphic novel. Alex Ross, if you guys remember, debuted with Mark Waid on Kingdom Come, right?
Yeah.
Marvel's.
DC's Kingdom Come.
Okay, but Marvel's was first.
Okay, fine, fair enough. But he worked on DC's Kingdom Come afterward with Mark Waid, right?
See?
And that was the whole thing about, like, Superman... like fucking rehabilitating all of the younger superheroes and stuff, right?
See?
And they drew influence from the original Mark Greenwald Scar Supreme miniseries.
For the young kids?
For the younger kids.
Because they were assholes.
In 1986, Mark Greenwald, who always wanted to work on, he died, but he always wanted to work on Superman and Batman and all those other guys, always wanted to work on Justice League title, never got a chance to, decide he's going to work on the Marvel stand-ins for those characters with Hyperion and Nighthawk and stuff, right? And so he decided to make a story that was a logical conclusion for them, which was that these guys who have godlike powers will just rehabilitate the world, get rid of crime, get rid of hunger, get rid of poverty, everything. And so these guys did at the cost
in
of...
In America. In
the world, actually.
Fuck the world. In America.
They did it in America first.
America.
Across the world.
America!
At the cost of freedom.
Yeah.
And their Batman stand-in, Nighthawk, was the only person who stood against them and stuff, right? And that influenced Kingdom Come, and that influenced Brad Meltzer's Identity Crisis and all these other books for years to come and stuff. So, to me, Alex Ross drawing this cover is an homage to, like, recognizing... the fact that, you know, Squadron Supreme started it. This was it. These were the first guys to think of bringing superheroes to a logical Watchmen-like conclusion, actually. They did it first, actually. That's cool. What I think it is.
Couple of quick questions before we close out the show. Sino Ross, or I guess it's Sino Ross, hit us up on YouTube and said, so Pete, what are your thoughts on the Dark Tower movie so far with the possible changes being made? I am not aware of any changes besides the fact that they're going to make Roland Deschain black.
Idris Elba, right?
And if it's Idris Elba, I'm fucking totally cool with that.
Yeah.
Because he's a damn good actor.
Idris Elba is awesome.
So, Sino, if there's any other changes, please hit me up and let me know. I would love to discuss this. Hit us up, questions at peachbasement.com, facebook.com/peachbasement, and of course, follow us on Instagram and Twitter for up-to-the-minute reviews and rumors and all sorts of interesting comic book news and just funny shit. We've been by the way, guys, we're up to like 11,600 followers.
11.8,
really?
11.8. Yeah, you announced 11.7 like earlier this week.
I am a little behind the times then.
You have more followers than Squadron Supreme, dude.
That is fucking fantastic. 11.7. That is incredible. Thank you all for that. Jonathan Moreno will close out the show. What do you guys think about the rumors of Marvel making Iron Fist Asian for the upcoming Netflix TV show? Those are false rumors, sir.
There's a lot of false rumors out
there. He is not going to be Asian. He is going to be American. Marvel is not changing things.
You could be Asian and American.
You could be Asian and American.
You meant Caucasian.
I meant Caucasian.
Okay.
But I'm prejudiced, and prejudice is funny. So it is what it is.
As we established ourselves.
He's still going to be a white dude. They are not mixing Iron Fist and Shang-Chi because, simply, Marvel is not going to eliminate a separate cash cow that will be Shang-Chi. Shang-Chi will be another fucking awesome show, which will probably if it will not have its roots in Iron Fist, the Yellow Kid. Yes, the Yellow Kid.
Wow, that's funny.
You may catch a couple of hints to Shang-Chi in Iron Fist when it starts filming in April in our neighborhood. Come the
it's 2006, here, man.
2016, man.
Nice.
We're gonna be filming in April, so we're gonna have to stalk the fucking areas.
Hell yeah.
We gotta talk to our buddy Tommy Walker, man.
Yes.
He might
yes.
have some insight into this.
Let's hope
but
so.
But he won't tell us.
But we can just stalk him and in turn find stuff out. Like, I don't mind standing outside of his room and fucking like a hotel room in my trench coat and nothing else. Whatever, it's gotta be done.
Wow, that's a visual I need right now.
I need that visual.
Are we done?
Jonathan asks, personally, I like Iron Fist as a white guy because the whole dynamic with Luke Cage, so don't worry, Jonathan, he will be. A black guy and a white guy teaming up together to fight bad guys is really cool.
I agree.
So, also, yeah. Both of them in a biracial relationship, which is also cool. At the same time, I don't mind Iron Fist being Asian since there has been other Iron Fists in the past. Either way, I'm stoked for the show to come out. Don't worry, Marvel is making Shang-Chi on their own. It's going to be another show. Look forward to that, probably in sometime in Phase 4. Marvel's got a lot of plans, bro. Spider-Woman's coming. Fucking Moon Knight's coming. Mm. We already know for a fact Punisher is coming.
Yeah.
Punisher's coming in Daredevil, and it will get its own series.
I hope he gets to kill Andrew Lincoln Andrew Lincoln plays a bad guy, so he gets to shoot him back.
Who's Andrew Lincoln?
Andrew Lincoln is Rick from
Rick from Walking Dead.
I would love for him
that great would that be?
That would be great. That would be amazing. That would be.
Oh, that's fucking turnabout is fair play.
Yeah.
Yes,
have
I didn't
Andrew
know
Lincoln
that.
Play like,
make it happen, Marvel.
Yeah,
make
Marvel.
It happen.
Bring him in as a bad guy.
Oh, yeah. That's awesome. I didn't know that. That's great.
Yeah, have him do it.
So that about does it for us at the Pete's Basement Show, guys. Once again, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for entering the contest. Be sure to email us your addresses if you did enter the Star Wars contest. Send us your address if you are subscribed for the month of December, and we will hook you up. Meanwhile, stay tuned. We will be back come 2016. We're taking off for 2 weeks for Christmas and New Year's. We will be back in 2016.
Happy
New
Year.
Don't forget about the Millennials Contest. It is our first contest of 2016. We're going to end this, not the first show, but the second show of 2016,
okay.
Which, let me just check my dates here.
4 weeks.
Just check my dates. Check my dates.
4 weeks from last night.
Who's going to be there?
And it is going to be January 14th that we are going to give away three copies of Millennials. If you want, why don't you come back to the show that day?
I will be back that day.
Fantastic. Ooh. Clear your schedules out, folks. So we'll be back then. We'll be back the week of the 7th of 2016. I see Trish in the background kind of raising her arms up doing gang symbols at me, which leads me to believe that I've forgotten something.
Are we not doing a spoiler episode after this?
We are doing a spoiler episode after this, but it's going to be on the Extras channel.
Okay, but
Extras.
So guys, if you're on Periscope and you have already seen Star Wars, you can stay tuned and watch that.
Same bad channel?
If you haven't seen Star Wars, I highly recommend that you turn the motherfucker off right now. Because I don't want to hear some shit that we're spoiling things for you. Because we're going to spoil things for you.
We spoiled that Kylo Ren was two Ewoks, though.
We did spoil the fact that Kylo Ren is, in fact, two Ewoks stacked up together. Yes. Yep. So, guys, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
Happy
Hanukkah. Happy Kwanzaa. Happy Festivus.
Happy Life Day.
Happy Life Day. And I just want to say, guys, it's probably too late for all of us because we're of age and we're already subjected to the fucking stupidity of mankind. But enough with this Happy Holidays bullshit. Like, really? I'm sick of it. It's too generalized. I said Merry Christmas to a Jewish guy the other day, and he didn't explode. A Jewish guy said Happy Hanukkah to me, and I didn't melt into a little puddle of goo on the floor. Mm. So it's really high time that we start being tolerant of other people's religions and nationalities and celebrations without generalizing them into some fucking stupidity. Just say Merry Christmas. And if the dude's like, oh, I don't celebrate Christmas, that's okay. Because you're not wishing them a Merry Christmas. You're wishing them the happiness that you know with your family and your life and your heart and everything else. And just like he's wishing you a happy Hanukkah because that's what he fucking knows. No, I'm serious right now. I'm really serious.
No,
like, he's wishing you what the happiness that he knows just as you were doing the same to him. And I'm fucking sick of this goddamn generalization, the pussification of fucking America.
Yes.
Because we are just so afraid of insulting and offending somebody, but fuck that. By being scared shit of that, we're insulting and offending everyone. So let's just go fucking back to the way things were and say Merry Christmas, say fucking Happy Hanukkah, whatever fuck occurs to you, just fucking say it. And if somebody gets offended, you just tell them, like, yo, don't be offended, man. Just let it roll. That's just it. Like, just fucking be real with it, man. Forget this bullshit. And now you know.
Is half the battle.
We'll see you guys next year.
Pete's Basement is copyright 2015, Rift Productions, and Pete's Basement LLC. All rights reserved, so go fuck yourself.
Babies! They're babies!
Oh. Pete gave me the clap.
That's at least pretty new.
Who? Yeah.
What?
Cheeseburger's mic is not working.
Cheeseburger's mic is in his shirt.